Unmarket Your Business, the podcast. Born out of the need to share strategies and techniques that really work to market your business. Think yellow page ads and cold calls are your only choices? That's so last century. You're about to learn tested, tried and true marketing techniques you can apply and master. Ones that feel authentic instead of salesy. Strategies that are true to who you are and how you want to present yourself to your ideal clients. Let's join our host, Carol Joyce Dunlop, in the studio now and allow business success to move forward. No sales, no business. If you want to know exactly how to build an audience that buys from you over and over again, I'll share the step-by-step method to do it. But first, are you striving to create your first or next 10K month? Me too. Join me every Tuesday at 10 a.m. Eastern in my Facebook group, Unmarket Your Business. Go to csicorporation.com/FB group to join right now. Hey, you're just in time for the next training, which happens this coming Tuesday, how to create landing pages that convert.
Some knowledge belongs to us and us alone. The way our girlfriends walk, the way they talk, the way they touch their hair. We hold details that only a sister can know about her girls. But what about our other girls? The ones that we carry with us every day. Can we describe them when everything's right? Can we feel when something's wrong? Our bond with our sister girls gives life. But knowing your breasts can save it. You don't know go to knowyourgirls.org for the facts you need on breast health. That's knowyourgirls.org, brought to you by Susan G. Coleman and the Ad Council.
Hey, everyone. It's Carol J. Dunlop, your hostess with the mostest. I'm known as the Online Wow Strategist and Amazon number one international best-selling author for my book, Unmarket Your Business, 10 Ways for Savvy Entrepreneurs to Stand Out, Stop Struggling, and Start Profiting. Have you checked out my new blog on Unmarket Your Business? Here's a snippet, and this is part of what we're talking about today, so listen up.
Now, let's get back to the sales funnel creation. Step 1, get to know your audience. The very first step in creating your sales funnel is to figure out exactly who you're talking to. You can't market to the plant and you really don't want to because that would cost you so much money and time and energy. Besides, you wouldn't get the results you hoped for because your marketing would have to be so broad so it could appeal to anyone, which means that it would actually reach no one. Instead, let's figure out the exact one person that you'll use to represent your audience. I know what you're thinking. If I only talk to one person, I'm missing sales, right? Absolutely not. In actuality, by only talking to one specific, researched person or avatar that represents the audience you want to reach, you make each individual person you come in contact with feel special. That person feels that you know them, really know them, which makes them feel trust towards you. Trust means that they're more apt to buy from you. See how that works? Shane Barker, a guest blogger at Mention, really breaks down the whole sales funnel process. Check out the full post. How to build a killer sales funnel. Your clarity journey. Let's embark on your clarity journey. This journey involves you getting to know your avatar as intimately as possible so that when she, I will use she because that's who my avatar represents, finds you, she knows she's in the right place. Get some paper so you can fill in the following information. Give your avatar a name. Age. Gender. Hair color. Eye color. Marital status. Where do they live? Suburb, city, country, etc. Annual income. Favorites. Books. Movies. TV shows. Podcasts. Magazines. Blogs. Conferences, workshops, seminars they attend. Hobby. Mentors. Who do they follow? Authors. Speakers. Actors/actresses. Singers. Brands. Guilty pleasures. Employee, type of job. Entrepreneur, type of business. Tip, look at the magazine, website, shopping site your avatar would most likely visit and grab a picture to use that represents them to you in real life. From this information, you now have a real representation of the people who will eventually become your clients. Short on time? Download a PDF version of this blog post and go through it at your own pace.
You're listening to the Unmarket Your Business podcast. I hope that info got you to thinking. Be sure to check out the rest of the article at unmarket.csicorporation.com/blog. Once you complete your sales funnel, it works on its own 24/7 to bring in prospects who convert into clients. So we're going to continue that, and I'll show you how to create a buying audience, rather an audience that buys over and over again. Okay, next step. After you get to know your audience and learn what they want, you know their pain points, you know the solution you provide, and you know all this good stuff, you've built like the very core of what your marketing and sales funnel needs to have, and you're on your way to being able to do this over and over again in anything that you put out so that your audience is going to look for it and they're going to be primed to buy. All right, next step. The next step is to get leads coming in. And here's three ways that you can do it, and this works for me every single time. The first one is speaking. So you can speak live and in person, on your own stage, on someone else's stage. Did you know you can use meetup.com to do that? So if you go to meetup.com, set up an account, I think it's $14 a month or something, you can actually promote what you're doing in that meetup account and then have people meet you every month or how often you're going to meet. I would suggest no more than every other month, but once a month would be great, where they come together with you, you bring them in, you teach them, you know, something each time, and then at the end you make an offer to work with you. Now, you don't have to make an offer each time, but I would definitely have something there for them to purchase or buy or join or whatever. And Meetup is a great thing to use because Meetup does all the heavy lifting for you. When you sign up for that account, they're going to go out and promote your Meetup to their thousands and thousands of members over and over again. I have an organization that I work with, and we started Meetup in order to really bring some younger blood in because all of us were over 50 in the group. And so we said, well, you know, hey, we're over 50, so we're getting older. We need some younger people in here, and we want to reach the 30-plus-year-olds. So we set up a Meetup group. We have not really done anything to it or anything with it. We just set it up, and we did it about a year ago, and we have over 1,500 members in there. Now, that's with not really doing anything, but a lot of the people who join our organization come from Meetup, find out about us on Meetup, and follow us on Meetup. And a lot of those people who have joined have now become committee members and VPs. They're instrumental in the things that we're doing. So get to speaking. Get out there. Get to speaking. Get the word out because it's the best way for you to get in front of your target audience so they get to know you, like you, trust you, start buying from you. The other way that you can get out there and get leads coming in is writing on your blog, writing articles, writing even on your posts, write in guest posting, which I'll cover that in just a second. But just start writing. Just put some stuff out there. You've got a wealth of information in your brain, and people need to hear it. They need to know how to act on it, and they need to know that you wrote it, that you have this magnificent, brilliant brain, and you're out there doing great things, so they want to be a part of that. So remember, you can write. You can write on your blog. You can write articles for yourself. You can even submit articles for other publications. Huffington Post is a big one, of course. They may not take just everyone, but there are other smaller publications that you can also write for. And then the third way, of course, is guesting, guest blog posting, guest article writing. So those are really huge because actually you're going to connect with someone who already has an audience, and then you're going to write a blog or an article that they're going to present to their audience, introduce you to them. These people find out about you, follow you, right back to your website. Boom, that's what you wanted, right? So use speaking, writing, and guesting to get yourself out of there in front of the people who could possibly buy from you. Now, on the blog that you heard earlier, there is a graphic that I have on there that shows you, let's see, 32 places to promote your business for free, and is using each of these elements. So go and check that out. And that's at unmarket.csicorporation.com/blog. All right, so now you have your funnel together, your marketing funnel together. You know the pain points that your people have. You know the solution that you offer. You also are speaking and writing and guesting, so you can let people know that you're there and they're following you. What is the next step? The next step is getting people to trust you. Know, like, trust, buy. People buy from people they know, like, and trust. And you can be in that number pretty quickly. Sometimes, I have to be honest, sometimes it takes up to 27 touches for someone to actually open their virtual wallet and buy from you. 27 times. So if it takes them up to 27 times for them to see you, to hear you, to read something you've written, to hear someone else talking about you, to go back to your website, to download something, to watch a video, you know, all those things are kind of interconnected. And you never know when someone is going to make that move to say, hey, they've hit that button for me, I'm ready to go, here's my, what can I buy from you, here it is, here's my credit card, charge it. So when you build up that know, like, and trust factor, they are going to buy from you because they are your target audience. You already know their pain, you have a solution, you know what they want, so it just works together. You don't have to work that hard for it, it just works together. All right, we're coming up on the next step, which is inviting your audience to work with you. Now, I just told you about how you get them to know, like, and trust you, and then they're going to buy from you. Great. Sometimes people don't know what the next step is. This is where your call to action or CTA comes in. You have to tell them, hey, download this. Hey, click that button. Hey, enroll now. You have to tell them, because if you build a landing page or a sales page and you send people to it and they read all this stuff and they get to the end, they don't automatically know what to do, how to purchase this thing or how to get involved in this system or this program or how to attend this event. Whatever it is you're trying to sell to them, you have to tell them. And don't think you're being pushy. It's just giving direction, because the thing is, when people see you, they get involved with what you're doing, they're like you, and they're ready to go. They're not really thinking about what's my next step. Do I push this button or do I call you? You know, you don't want them to have to think about stuff. You want them to read the information, agree with it, know that you are the one for them, that you're solving the problem. And then the next thing should be just obvious. Here's a big old red button. Buy now. Here's a big old red button. Enroll now. Here's a big red button. Get your ticket now. Whatever it is, you don't want them to have to think, because if you get them out of that trance that they're in when they're on the sales page, you could possibly lose them for good. Because if they click away from that page, or if they don't understand what to do, or if they have some questions about where do I go from here, you might have lost them for good. Once they get off that page, they're most likely not coming back, unless you just sit, you know, hit something and burned within them, like, I got to go to this, I got to do this. How many times have you done it? How many times have you gone to a page or a post or whatever, and you're like, oh, that sounds good, I'm going to go back to it. And when you try to go back, you can't even find the thing. You don't even know where it was or where you even saw it. So get them right there. Show them, this is what you need to do. You want this object, you want to attend this event, you want to read this book or whatever, click this, enroll now, buy this. Make sure that you show them what they need to do. The other thing is, when you have your marketing or sales funnel all together and it's working, people are coming in, you know, all look at the funnel like an ice cream cone. At the top, you got all these people coming in, and then it gets very small, so it spits out clients at the bottom. Some people are going to drop off between when they come into your funnel and becoming a client. So that's okay. You don't want those people anyway, or they're not ready, or you're not quite the person for them, or maybe you're too much for them, maybe you're too much behind them, maybe they're ahead of you, and maybe vice versa. It doesn't matter. We're getting to the point where we want the clients to drop out of the bottom, right, and get into your tribe. So if one of your pieces of your funnel is to get someone on the phone with you or on a Zoom or on a Skype session with you so that you can actually see them, talk to them, hear their voice, and all of that, then at the end, when you get finished, you have to tell them what they need to do next. I have a story for you. Years ago when I was a personal trainer and I put up my website and weight loss coach and I was promoting myself, putting all these things out there. I remember this one lady got on the phone. We actually got on the telephone, right? And unheard of. Got on the phone and we were talking. We got to the end and I didn't know what to do. I hadn't really studied my craft of sales and pitching and closing deals, although I knew I had done it before in the real world, but on the phone and in this new thing that I was doing of being a weight loss coach. And you know, I'm usually up front with people. They're sitting in front of me, and we're talking, and I'm sliding a contract over for them to sign. So I didn't know what to do. So anyway, we got to the end, and it was kind of this awkward pause. And she said, "So what programs do you have? You know, what are your offers?" At that moment, I felt totally lost. I felt like, huh? You know, and I knew I had stuff to sell. But the one big mistake that I had made is I didn't have it packaged enough so I could really just sell it. So I could say, this is the thing I want you to do, or this is what I want you to do, or this will be perfect for you. Let me explain about it. I wasn't quite versed in all of that. I was really just getting my sea legs on. So needless to say, I did not get that sale because it wasn't a sale to get. I never offered her anything. I never invited her to work with me. I never said, hey, come on board. Which car do you want me to put this on? I never said any of that. So if I didn't tell her what to do, she obviously didn't know what to do. So she was like, okay, well, we'll talk later. Bye. And I'm like, bye. So I don't want you to be in that position. So whether someone is coming in through your funnel and they're going through the automated system and they purchase something small or they purchase something big, or whether you have them in your funnel and it's to get on the phone or Skype or Zoom with them and you're actually talking to them, you got to have that point where you invite them to work with you, where you say, can I tell, you know, I have this great program. I think it's going to be great for you. Can I tell you about it? Let them say yes, and then you go into your pitch. You tell them, and your pitch doesn't have to be, oh, my God, this is so scary. No, it doesn't have to be scary. It needs to be part of the conversation. It's not like, okay, we're talking, and then all of a sudden I'm selling. It's like, okay, I've listened to you. I know what your problems are. I know what your issues are. I have the solution. Can I share that with you? Great. All right, this is what I think you should do. Blah, 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 blah. And to take advantage of that, it'll be $1,500. How would you like to take care of that today? Which card would you like to use? Basic, easy, just get it out. Just practice saying that, because that is part of the marketing and sales funnel. That is actually the end of it, right? Because remember, we have this big funnel looking like an ice cream cone, and all these people are dropping in, and they're going through all of our stuff that we set up for them, and they get to the end, and it spits out a client. It won't spit out a client unless you invite them to work with you. Now you've got the client. They said yes. They've paid you. It's time for you to start nurturing them. Nurturing them means you are continually feeding them, just like a little baby who comes into the world with nothing. What do you do with that kid? You feed it, you clothe it, you bathe it, you give it so much love, and it grows up into a, hopefully a great, awesome citizen, someone that you'll be proud of. But you got to do your clients the same way. When they come in to your marketing funnel and they're spit out as a client, you can't just leave them there. You can't just say, hey, here's this thing that you bought. See you later. You got to keep up with them. You got to say, hey, how are things doing? Send them an email. Maybe send them some things that are going to help them in doing whatever it is you tell them that they can do. Because you got to fulfill your promise. If you promise them that they will be able to do this one thing from working with you, you better be ready to deliver on that, or at least see where they're falling short. Because if they're falling short, it means that something that you did is not quite processing in their brain. I had a client just the other day. We were talking. I finished her website. She's getting ready to launch it. And she says, Carol, I need to know how to access my email. And she also needed access to her website. So I sent her an email. I was like, this is the information for you to access your website. Here's your username, password. And then further down, I was like, and this is how you set up your email account. You can actually pull it in through Gmail, and here's a video for you. Well, for some reason, either I didn't make it clear enough or she didn't understand that these were two separate things. It wasn't go into the back of your website and get your email. It was go into the back of your website and see how things work. And this other thing is how you access your email. So she was just totally confused. I mean, technology confuses people, and you got to be ready for that. You may not be dealing with technology. You may be dealing with a recipe, and you tell them and you explain the recipe to the T, but they still don't understand, do I use a pot for this or a pan? How much is this? How long is it going to take? You know, whatever it is, you got to be prepared for their questions and to answer it. So what did I do? I jumped on a Zoom with her, shared her screen, and showed her, okay, this is how you do it. She was like, oh, gosh, now I understand. Oh, da-da-da-da-da. Sorry about that. No problem. It was just, you know, people are busy. They're dealing with so many things. They got kids or grandkids or, you know, spouses, and they're running their business, and they have things going on with their girlfriends and their best friends and all that. So they may just not look at things as closely as you think they should. So you got to be ready to nurture them and help them, because helping them achieve the success that you promised that they would have is a win-win for both of you. It means that you win because they achieved what you said they would, and they win because they got out of it what they thought they would get out of it. You're listening to the Unmarket Your Business podcast. All right, last step coming up. The final step in building an audience that will buy is so simple. It's wash, rinse, repeat. Do the whole thing over. Keep your sales funnel running. Keep those get those leads coming in. Keep speaking. Keep guest posting. Keep writing your blog and articles. Keep doing all that stuff, because that's bringing in the leads that are going into the top of the funnel. They're going to shake all the way down to the bottom where it spits out clients, and then you nurture them. And then guess what else happens? The big win for both of you is those clients that they spit out, that you nurture and help them achieve their success, they become raving fans and brand advocates for you. They're saying, I worked with Carol, and she helped me achieve this great marketing strategy that I use over and over and over and over and over again. It brings in clients. I'm so happy. You need to work with her too. That's what I'm talking about. Brand advocate, raving fans, people that can't stop talking about you, how great and awesome you are, and get others ready to work with you, and just really being your ambassador out there that's bringing you clients so you don't have to do all the work yourself. You got an army of people who are out there advocating for you. Isn't that awesome? That is how you create a buying audience, and that is how you keep building it so that they go on and on and on and on and on forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. So that's all I have for you today. I hope that it has benefited you. I hope that you've gotten a lot out of it. And when you read that article, it tells you step by step how to create your marketing funnel, a marketing funnel that converts visitors and tire kickers and people who are like, oh, what is this about, into paying clients. And I want that for you. If you have any questions, or if you're like, I just really don't understand this thing, Carol, can you help me? Please, I would love you to connect with me so we can actually talk. We can get on a Zoom or a Skype or get on the phone or whatever, and we can solve the problem so you can start making the money and getting the clients. All you need to do is go to csicorporation.com/onlinewow and sign up for my online wow assessment. It's totally free. There's no charge to it. We're going to take about 45 minutes to look at your website and your online presence and see where you're missing out on clients and what you need to do to stop it. I can't wait to talk to you and help you out in that way. So thank you so much for joining me, and I'll see you again next time. Thanks for listening. We truly appreciate it. For information about guests, products, or services that were mentioned in this episode, log on to our website at www.csicorporation.com/unmarketing. To learn more, get a glimpse of our upcoming schedule, and join the Unmarketing Nation of entrepreneurs who are using marketing techniques that work right now. Until next time, keep moving forward.